Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Dell just keeps on adding new units to their PowerEdge MX7000 blade enclosure, and I think it's about time we revisited the MX7000 enclosure. It's designed to support multiple generations of CPUs, and today we'll be looking at the Dell EMC PowerEdge MX750c blade server. This is the latest one, or at least the latest one that we've received in-house. The MX750c supports third generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors with a definite performance boost from more cores, PCIe 4.0, and more memory channels. Without further ado, let's dive in. The MX750c looks just like the MX740c. However, the MX740c supported first and second generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors, while the MX750c is outfitted with those third generation processors, which also have a slightly larger socket, so there's no going back. At the same time, what's a blade server without the enclosure? Kind of like a katana without a samurai warrior to wield it. For that job, there's the MX7000 enclosure. By the way, you can see the MX7000 video by clicking that link, and I placed a few other links in the description below for the other blades supported on the system, specifically the dual-socket MX740c and quad-socket MX840c. There is a storage blade capable of supporting up to 16 SAS drives, but no video for that last one, yet. And yes, I will again talk about the MX7000 chassis, just in case you didn't want to bother with all those other separate videos. The Dell EMC PowerEdge MX7000 chassis was released in August of 2018. It offers a kinetic infrastructure for the modern software-defined data center. It provides the power, cooling, central management, and networking. The blades provide the compute, memory, and storage. The server nodes on the MX7000 connect directly to the I/O and storage modules. There is no mid-plane board used as an interface between the I/O and storage modules, like on the M1000E, which is the obsolete blade enclosure this one replaces. Instead, new technologies can be installed on the server sleds, which connect directly to the I/O modules through an orthogonal connection. Those I/O and storage modules on the back of the MX7000 can be switched out, while the PCI mezzanine cards on the server nodes that connect to those modules can be upgraded and replaced too. No mid-plane board is required, which means less parts to fail. Are you interested in the Dell EMC PowerEdge MX750 server blade? First, maybe I should ask if you have the MX7000 chassis. Let's assume you do. But if you don't, and you need one or the other or both, for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the purchase price that's listed on our site, or one that you can configure at $5,000 or more. Just mention this video. Oh, and we also have the MX740C and that MX840C, not to mention the components, memory, storage, plus those modules. Better make a list. The MX7000 chassis can support 8 single-wide blades, 4 double-wide blades, or a combination of the two. There's even been talk of half-height modules in the future, so perhaps up to 16 of those. There are currently only 4 modules supported on the system, the MX740C, MX840C, MX5016S, exclusively for storage, and the server sled we have today, the MX750C. Notice the little S and C on those names? For storage and compute. There are 6 hot-swappable platinum-rated 3000-watt PSUs located in the lower front portion of the chassis. Above those, 4 60mm fans arranged vertically right down the center and control panels to either side. With compute and storage sleds on the front arranged vertically, and modules in back arranged horizontally, each blade could connect to I/O fabrics A and B, plus the storage C fabric and management modules. I will mention there is the potential to install 2 of each of the modules for redundancy, but not required. There are also 5 more fans in back pulling that DRAM and PMEM-scented air out of the chassis. Offering dual CPU sockets, the MX740C and MX750C are single-width compute modules. The MX740C supports first and second generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors and 6 storage bays. The MX750C also has 4 to 6 bays, but with support for third generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors. Featuring up to 4 CPUs is the 8-bay MX840C, also with support for first and second generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors. Both the MX740C and MX750C can provide almost 8 terabytes of memory at capacity, while the MX840C can deliver a little over 15 terabytes of memory. All can be outfitted with persistent memory modules, but only the MX840C and MX740C can host non-volatile DIMMs using first-generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs. However, the additional battery required for MD DIMMs will reduce the number of active drive bays on the MX840C to 6. The single-width MX5016S storage module can house up to 16 hot-swap 2.5-inch SAS drives. It supports a by-4 SAS connection to each of the 8 front-facing sled bays in the MX7000 chassis. 1-7 MX5016S storage modules can be installed, but you will need at least one of the compute modules to connect to. And of course, at least one MX5000C fabric module in the back of the chassis. About a week after Intel's announcement of the third generation Xeon Scalable processors in March of 2021, Dell announced the Dell EMC PowerEdge MX750C with support for third generation CPUs. Third generation Xeon Scalable processors offer 8 to 40 physical cores and 16 to 80 virtual threads, depending on the SKU. I will mention at this point that only the Platinum versions support 40 cores, while Gold will max out at 32 cores and Silver at 20 cores. Still, Platinum and Gold offer a significant boost from the 28 cores available on the first and second generation Xeon Scalable processors. This particular chassis came with dual Gold 32-core 6338 CPUs with a 205-watt TDP, 48 megabytes of cache, and a base clock of 2 gigahertz. Third-gen Scalable CPUs also support faster and high-performing memory with 8 memory channels instead of only 6. Maximum memory at up to 7.68 terabytes is achieved using 16 200 series persistent memory modules paired with 16 RDIMMs. While the MX740C will provide the same memory count, it uses 100 series persistent memory modules. But there is still a memory boost using the standard DDR4 LRDIMM and RDIMM memory with support for up to 4 terabytes compared to only 3 terabytes on the MX740C using only DDR4. Memory speeds of up to 3200 megahertz can be achieved with Platinum and Gold, or only 2933 megahertz using Silver. PCIe 4.0 delivers twice the bandwidth compared to PCIe 3.0 as on the MX740C, and provides better performance for I/O modules and NVMe storage. There is a configurable TDP limit of 270 watts on CPUs that can be installed in the MX750C, which really isn't a limit considering that's the top TDP listing for third generation Scalable processors. The larger socket design means the motherboard is incompatible with the first and second generation CPUs. The MX750C supports 4-6 hot plug SAS, SATA, or NVMe storage devices, depending on the backplane. Outfitted with the universal backplane, cables for the NVMe drives can be plugged directly into the system board with 3 PCIe Gen 4x8 connectors. A dedicated PCIe 4.0x16 socket for a PowerEdge RAID controller is available for support of SAS, or just more control over SATA. If SATA drives are used, they can find limited RAID support provided by the integrated Intel S150 controller on the blade. There are quite a few options for support of both local and external drives, like those provided by the MX5016S storage module. A mini mezzanine connector plugs into the storage fabric C module, MX5000, for a seamless SAS fabric connection without any cables. The MX7000 offers embedded agile management of all components. 2 redundant MX9002M management modules support the embedded management solution, the Dell OpenManage Enterprise Module Edition, or OME. I will mention that at the compute sled level, each is equipped with the integrated Dell Remote Access Controller, or iDRAC 9 modules, that connect to the MX9002M management modules for comprehensive coverage of individual, multiple servers and chassis. QuickSync 2, which uses the OpenManage mobile app, also provides options for at-chassis management of the system. There are 2 PCIe 4.0x16 mezzanine slots for mezzanine fabrics A and B respectively, each with 2 connectors for redundancy if you install 2 I/O fabrics. Another x16 slot is for a mini mezzanine card connecting to fabric C, assuming you include a storage module and storage blade in the enclosure. There is a dedicated PCIe 3.0 slot for a boot-optimized subsystem, or BOS, that can be outfitted with dual M.2 drives in mirror mode for redundancy. Or you can install a dual SD card module, DSDCM, to support a hypervisor and features 2 SD cards on one side and a flash drive on the other. That flash drive can be used by iDRAC to support system firmware updates and patches. An internal USB connector at the back of the blade also provides options for additional storage or support of a limited OS. But you can't have both as the cards use the same slot. A dedicated slot on the side is used for an internal PERC controller like an HBA 3050iMX or H755MX. That H755MX will support SAS, SATA, or NVMe drives, depending on the backplane and server configuration. While the Dell EMC PowerEdge MX750C may look like the MX740C, it's got some serious upgrades under the hood with the help from those dual third-generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors. More compute power, faster memory, plus better I/O and NVMe support with PCIe 4.0. I think we'll be seeing more blades, and like I said in one of those other videos, links down below, hopefully an AMD EPYC-based system soon. And at this point, I'm hoping for at least a third generation AMD EPYC system. If you are looking for this blade, then check out itcreations.com. We have this one, the MX740c, MX840c, and the MX7000 in stock right now. That MX5016 storage module, we can get too. Just give us a few days. Although by the time you see this video, we might have that one too. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.